Hey, what's up guys? It's Mario back again with another trade video. Today I'm going to go over a trade that I made on AMD. Now, AMD is part of the semiconductor sector. They are actually famously known for having a lot of great chips for gaming computers, like the one you see behind me on the background. So today I'm going to go over how I actually day traded this stock, the AMD stock, and how I made money. Now I'm going to go over overall fundamentals of the sector, the semiconductor sector, also the market conditions, the NASDAQ, the S&P 500, as well as how the AMD stock has been trading the last couple of days. So I'm going to go over how I day traded on a low hanging fruit short because I felt like I needed a relief pullback, because it was extended in the daily chart. And also, we did have some news yesterday. It was some good news that to me felt like it was a buy the rumor, sell the news type of event. And I noticed a price action telling me that, hey, you know, a lot of large investors are taking opportunity on this news to take some profits, and there might be some more downside. So let's get started now. Don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe to this channel below. Now let's get started. Let me share my screen so I could go over that trade. All right, so here we go. So what I'm looking at here is in terms of AMD is looking at the long-term chart. You know, it's been definitely trending. Now, and it's just not just AMD, but also the sector. Now the semiconductor sector, here I have the SMH. This is an ETF that tracks the semiconductor sector. It's been trending very nicely the last year, and specifically the last, you could say, week. I mean, it's been having 1, 2, 3, 4. Today's the fifth day, and days in row in terms of up, green days, and it's overextended on the daily chart. Now, AMD is the same way, pretty much. Now, going over a yearly chart, it's pretty much broke over all-time highs. And there was this huge resistance level of 92. And it felt like that this level was not going to pretty much, it was going to kind of, you know, pull back toward this kind of level. Now, let me look, kind of go over the Bollinger Bands. So if you look at the Bollinger Bands, it broke above, which indicates overbought. And yesterday, now this candle right here, see how it kind of looks like a big wick, right here? That was a telltale sign that a red day or a pullback was coming. Now this is all based in news. So if I show you in the chart the day before, let me show you. There you go. So yesterday, Wednesday, there was some news. There was a press release in AMD's website that said that AMD. Actually, the AWS or Amazon Web Services expanded the offering with a new cloud with AMD chips. So that was great news for AMD. So we at the morning we had this huge spike, but it kind of didn't help. You know, it kind of sold off right away. It went below the volume and the average price, which is this purple line, and literally just downtrended all day. So to me, especially now that it kind of is testing all-time highs here around 94, to me that kind of told me that, hey, you know what? I think there might be a pullback in AMD coming. I think tomorrow might be a good opportunity to short it. So that's pretty much what I did. And I was actually looking to short here at the pit at the midpoint, 95 or even higher, but I decided not to short in the midpoint just because, you know, it was kind of trying to pre-market, and it felt that if I do get in at 94, which is kind of like the midpoint, it might keep going to 95 or above. So my first entry was actually 95. Now, it didn't hit. I missed it by a couple cents, but as soon as the market opened, it pulled back right away. It literally sold off right away, and that to me was like, okay, this is going to go down. I really see this. I kind of see it in the price action. I think we're going to get a nice pullback. So the other thing that I was looking at is actually this trend right here, pre-market. So I wanted to kind of make sure this thing kind of broke. And it did break. It broke below this 9360, a pre-market level that I was really interested in. It kind of sold off, broke below that, bounced off, and this 9360 held, and it started to kind of come back, and I started to short. I did end up shorting around 9330s, and my target was this S1 pivot level. Now, it didn't quite get there how I want it. It kind of sold off. It bounced up this 9250. You know, the whole numbers and half dollars are always bounce areas, are always targets for many traders. Now, the only mistake I made actually here is not covering half in the 9250 and maybe adding higher. But I wanted to kind of cover in the S1. I really felt the S1 was definitely doable just because of the price action the day before. So it kind of bounced off this 9250, this half dollar, and it kind of hit 93, very important intraday pre-market intraday level. And I was looking that, you know what, I was thinking that it might hit that and it might kind of come back and start trading, downtrend it again to the S1 pivot level here around 92. But it did it, you know, it was starting to hold. And my thought process was like, you know, if it continues to hold this 93 level and it reclaims the 93, I'm gonna stop out. You know, to me, that tells me, hey, you know what, I can't keep this trade because I think it might break above the volume weighted average price. It might even go green. And another reason why I thought that was because of how the market was moving. Now, if you look at the NASDAQ was definitely trending, and it was around the same time. It had a really strong move. And I felt, you know what, because AMD is part of the semiconductor sector and it's also part of the NASDAQ, I really think AMD could also go move with the NASDAQ. So that's the reason why I decided to cut it off and cover at 93 after I reclaimed 93. Now, eventually, it actually hit this important level again, 93.60, and it sold off and it hit the S1 level. Now, I do have a rule where I do trade only the first hour of the day just because overall, statistically, for me, it had the highest probability for me to make money. After the first hour, things get a little washy in terms of my odds and probabilities. So I tend to keep it within the first hour, and after the first hour, I'm done. So after I stopped out, I was pretty much done for the day, and that was pretty much it. Now, in terms of the sector, I feel like the sector, you know, especially looking at the SMH, the semiconductor sector ETF, I feel like there's a pullback. You know, it broke above the Bollinger Band, which again is an indicator that is overextended, and I think it might pull back. Now, the stock that I'm also looking at for tomorrow that I think could pull back is Micron, the Micron stock. You know, again, big, huge move, and today is holding above the Bollinger Band, but I think looking at the sector and the stock, there might be another pullback, another relief pullback tomorrow on Micron stock. So I think that could happen. So I may look at that tomorrow. So in terms of the overall trade, guys, again, I like to trade stocks that offer, especially day trading stocks that offer high probability of trade. Now, this trade is similar to Tesla, where the stock in a daily was extended over several days. And it was breaking above the Bollinger Bands, which to me gives me indication, hey, this stock is overextended. Not only that, but yesterday we had an exhaustion type of candle or exhaustion type of move where we had a huge move in the morning and then sold off right away and broke below the value weighted average price, which told me, hey, you know what? That was a telltale sign to me that there might be a pullback coming. Now, I hope you guys learned from this video. Don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe to the channel. You guys will see me soon. Have a good one, guys. Take care.